Hi love, this is Jing, the fashion director of Mossens. If this is your first time, click onto my video. Welcome to my channel. If it's not your first time, thank you so much for coming back. So today I'm going to share with you the 7 different styles of the most trendy winter boots this season. The first one is the knee-high boots, and there are 2 different styles under this category. So the first style is the street leg heels. I bought this one from Celine, and originally I got inspired from Kendall Jenner, and she wear a Saint Laurent one and by far one. It looks so amazing on the street shootings. I feel like this style is pretty classic, and it fits all sizes of different legs because the shaft part fits most calves. I found a similar one from my shoe draw from I bought last year. They look so similar. The main difference is the height of the shafts. So you wanna make sure the season you bought a height below your knee. And this one from Celine, I bought it because I feel they have a wider sole, so it's more comfy for walk. And also compare with the Saint Laurent one has 9 centimeter heel. This one is 8 centimeter. So when I wear that, it feels like a little bit easy to walk for like 2 or 3 hours. I love the detail in the ankle part. I also really love the leather has the natural shine on it. The other style is the stretchy leather. You may have them in your shoe drop, and I actually have 2 that I bought years ago. The first one is the Celine one. Compared to the street legs, this type of the boots will conform to the shape of your leg. So you may want to try them on and see whether it fits you the best. I believe it's from a 2018 fall collection. I would say for this one, compared to the street legs, it's more easy to step on because they all have either a square heel or the kitten heel. This one I bought from Chanel at least 5 years ago. I still really like it, and I found this season it became so popular again. So this season, I bought another one from Dior when I traveled in Paris. I would say among these 3, Dior, it's super easy to walk because it has the rubber sole, and the kitten heel is easy to step in. The main difference for these 3 pairs I found is the zipper part. So you wanna try and see which one is most easy for you to put on. The next style is the riding boots. I believe most of you may have it in your shoe drop, and this year it got a little updated from a hardwood sole to a rubber sole. So compare this one I bought last year. This one definitely has a really hard wood sole, and the front part is more flatted compared with the Celine one I bought this year. The Celine one has more spaces in the front. So let's say in the winter, we love to wear more like thicker socks to walk. This is more comfy and made for walking. And also for the shaft parts, it's more like street legs compared with the original idea of riding boots. May have more stiff or shaped shaft, so you can either wear jean with that, or you know, pair it with many other looks. I find this one is super practical for my daily wear. I pair it with shorts, hoodie sweaters, or with the jeans. It could be very cool or casual. One thing I recommended is that you want to wear them on and try to see whether it's comfortable for sitting. So the next style is slouchy boots. It's became more popular this season, and I found I have a couple of pairs I bought many years ago, but they became so popular this winter. So they also came in 2 different styles. One is with the street legs, like the one I'm holding in my hand, the Miu Miu one, and Isabella Marant. You can see, so the shaft part, it's folds and super soft, gives those natural folds by itself. And this one is made by lamb leather. The downside is that it's so delicate, and I only wore them 1 time and I broke the fronts. And this one is made of canvas. It's more durable. The next one is the stretchy leather. So it's kind of more like the knee-high boots. This has the stretchy leather options. This book from Proenza Schouler, I bought 2 years ago back then. When I see them on the fashion show, I love all the colors. Because when you see like this, you feel like it's really like kind of normal. But when you pull them on, it's give those natural folds to create those slouchy looks. And this one I love most because it looks so real, but actually it's faux leather. It's giving those fine leather look, but actually it's super durable. With the little square toe, which is very trendy, and the heel height, it's about 7 to 8. I will say it's pretty comfortable to walk in. So I have this color and I also bought the black color. I'm so happy to see this season, the brands bring it back and adding more colors. Alexander Wang dedicated his whole collection to slouchy boots this season, from denim to leather, from knee high to thigh high. I'm eyeing lots of pairs for myself and adding them to a Mawson's list. I will also including all the boots I mentioned in today's video to that list and share the link down below the description box to make it easier for you to check. The next popular style is the platform one. Actually, those are not limited for boots. We see all different type of the shoes with platform, and especially for boots, they came from all different designers and come out with the shorts boots, knee-high boots, thigh-high boots. I bought more than 10 pairs in the past 3 years, so I have 3 pieces of advice for you before your purchase. The first one, you want to make sure the whole boots are lightweighted. And I bought this R13 one 3 years ago and still one of my favorite because it has those foamy rubber sole. And for the boots part, the leather also super lighted. The same as the one, thigh high one from Stuart Weitzman, they have those foamy platform with a very light leather. So those two are my favorite. The next suggestion is you want the boots part more supportive. I have this 2 boots side by side to compare with. The only difference is the material of the boots. The left side is made with leather. The right side, the inner part is leather. The outside is canvas. When I bought this first, I feel like, oh my gosh, this is super easy and comfortable to walk. So I have to have the canvas one because I feel that will be even lighter, right? But because it's made of canvas outside part, it's not supportive enough. So make the shoes more flimsy and rub against my heel. I have another comparison, one from The Row. This one actually is super popular. And this one from Celine, they both have super thick platform, which means they are heavy. And because of The Row one, the boots part has more supportive made with leather. So I feel it's okay to walk, but this one, the Celine one, it's made of full canvas. So it's super flimsy and it's kind of my regrettable purchase. My third suggestion is to pay attention to the platforms because you want them formed to the shape of your feet. Otherwise, they could be very flat-footed and no give, make it so hard to walk. The next one is the Western style. You know, overall, the Western looks became so trendy this season. Lots of brand have from hat to toe look. And since I moved to Dallas, I found myself embraced to the Western culture. I have this cowboy boots in my boots collection, and one is from the Paris, Texas, from the brand, you know, they must have a lot of cowboy options. And this one with the cork and snake print make it super special and cute. And this one actually is a vintage Lucchese boots. This brand has 100 years histories, and these days they still carry their original design. So you can definitely find some authentic cowboy boots on their website. So when you wear those cowboy boots, you wanna find the design has the V cut in the front. That's really elongate your legs. Before I thought cowboy boots may, you know, more like Western style, but I saw a lot of girls in Dallas pair them with the maxi dresses. They're romantic and cute. And even like the brand Isabella Marant, they always have their cowboy boots collection every season and pair them with a flowery print dress, very feminine. And the brand Kate also have some cute options for you with those suede leather, square toe, very trendy. The next one is the snow boots. I feel like every of us at least have one pair of UGG in your shoe drop. And this one is super practical. I start wearing them since my college You can wear them with your loungewear, walk around the house, or dress them up with jeans and sweater. Because I wear them for many years, so I'm really a big fan of that, I started looking some elevated options. So today I want to give you some options if you like me, the snow boot fan. This one I bought from Brunello Cucinelli. They add those cinches on top and it's super cute. They don't have the like furry inside, but keeps the same warm, very comfortable. I see this year they also have those fur inside with the ankle style. Also like Moschino's or a Chloe also have those Sherilyn style outside. I will add them all into the Moss Sense list and share the link under the description box. Also, if you are a moon boots fan, I saw there is another brand called A La Nuit has a collaboration with them. Myself personally really eyeing them because they are a little pricey, so I add them to the Moss Sense list and waiting for some good deal as well. The last but not the least is the rain boots. I found those are super practical and everyone needed in their shoe drop. And this season, lots of like designers have great options, especially like Chanel. I used to be their rain boots collectors. I have their tall boots one and the short ones. They also have the middle height. I feel like I can wear them all year round for a long time. Whenever I invest in a designer boots, I want them to be practical. This year, I saw Chanel come out with a thigh-high rubber boots in the ready-to-wear collection, and every model pair them with a thicker socks with it. I understand the practical side, you know, keep you warm, but when thinking about the real daily wear, that's not really accentuate your body with all the thicker socks paired with the rubber boots. On the other hand, you know, I just couldn't justify the thigh-high boots in my daily wear, where I'm going to wear that. You know, just for fun, I did some research for those thigh-high fisherman rubber boots. They came out with the dupe option. It only cost $190 versus those $2,200 Chanel one. So if you guys are interested about that, I would definitely share the link in the description box for you guys. And back to, you know, the normal rain boots. There has a lot of great options from other designers, such as the Chloe Batty with 75mm. They are super cute. You can pair them with jeans or dresses, even if it's not a raining day. And like Valentino or Celine, they came every season, the most classic one. I feel that's a worth invest because they're never out of style. All right, loves, this is towards the end of today's video. I hope you enjoy watching and find your new favorite boots from the options I provided. If you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Love you guys and see you next time.